Congratulations, you just got a job. Congratulations, you just hit a million subscribers. Congratulations, you just bought a new car. Congratulations, you just got married. Congratulations and congratulations. Did you ever think, why do people congratulate anybody for anything? Well, that is because of these two planets. Which are the two planets? Yes, you guessed it right. It is because of Jupiter and Venus. If these two planets did not exist, there would be no congratulations. Neither would anybody feel like congratulating anybody, or neither would anybody be able to take any appreciation from anybody, because these two planets, they are the greatest of the benefics. They are the greatest benefics, in fact. And they control all the good things in life. Jupiter and Venus, most important planets. If somebody feels that they are lacking happiness in life, then there must be some issue with these two planets. And if somebody feels that I do not have much things in my life externally, but I'm still very happy, then that means these two planets are having very good placements. I mean, they are well placed, or they are well supported, I would say. Or they are, either ways, they are helping you. Why? Because they are the gurus. One is Jupiter, another is Venus. Well, generally they say Jupiter is the guru. They say, oh, guru is transiting in Scorpio now. It is going to enter Sagittarius from 5th November 2019. But most of the times we often forget that Venus is also the guru. He is the Daitya guru. He is Shukracharya. And he is also very important. Well, why? If you check the houses that these planets, they rule, or they are the Karaka of. Okay, so sometime back I had made a video, difference between the house lords and the Karakas. So if you have not watched it, then please go and watch it. So what are the house lords? House lords show the field of activity, and Karaka gives you the ultimate, the result, the essence, the goal, the vision. That's what the Karaka gives. And therefore, these two planets are very essential to analyze in anybody's chart. All right. And today we will discuss about them, hopefully in short. And yes, as usual, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you like this video, then please congratulate me by liking this. By clicking the thumbs up. And if you like this video, please share it with others and congratulate them also for anything in life. And if you want a consultation from me, then you can always go down to the description section of my videos to find the link to my website for booking a reading with me. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and he will congratulate you for no reason, maybe, but still, or you can congratulate him sometimes. All right, so why are these two planets so important? Because, of course, they are the greatest benefics. But what is that one thing which they give? They give a sense of liveliness in this world. Without these two planets, there will be no liveliness in this world. There is no charm. There is no feeling of being alive in this world. So therefore, these two are very essential, because these two are very much linked with the soul. Yes, Jupiter is linked directly, of course, and Venus is also linked. Now you may be thinking, how is Venus linked with the soul? Yes, it is linked. Because see, what is Jupiter? Jupiter gives you the higher wisdom, higher knowledge. Anything beyond matter, that's what Jupiter is. Well, before going to the higher side, let us discuss the mundane sides of these planets. And then let us go to the higher sides. And at the end, if time permits, we will also discuss one quick remedy for both of these two these planets. And for doing that remedy, you don't have to chant any mantras. You don't have to do anything. Just one simple thing you have to do. All right. So at a lower level, at a mundane level, at a materialistic level, these two planets can really get very much into materialism. Both the planets, I'm including Jupiter here. So at a mundane level, Venus will represent all the luxuries of this world. The sign Taurus. All the things that we eat and we touch. Taurus represents the sense organs. All right, especially the sense of touch is represented by Taurus. Anything that you touch, you know, this earphone, or I touch this mobile, anything, or this lighter, anything that I touch, that's Venus. All the luxuries, all the perfumes, all the things of beauty of this world is represented by Taurus. And it rules Libra, which rules relationships, marriage. Libra doesn't rule love relationships. More, it rules the house of marriage. It's the contract. It's a very fixed and a committed relationship. That's what Libra is. And Jupiter rules the second house of finances and family. And it rules the fifth house of children. It also, I mean, rules means it is the Karaka. It does not rule the fifth house, of course. And it is also not ruling the second house. It is the Karaka of the second house. And it is also the Karaka for the seventh house, the ninth house of father and elders, and the 11th house of friends and elder siblings. So these two represent all of these at a mundane level. All right, but and even if you see at a mundane level, these things provide a lot of happiness, because if you do not have these things in your life, whatever you have in your life, doesn't matter, you will be the most miserable person. You will be the most empty-hearted, depressed and lonely person in this world. I know so many people who have tons of wealth, tons of cars, tons of fame. They have so much fame that you just go and type their name in Google. The first letter you type, their name will pop up. Can you believe it? Just type C, their name will pop up. You write D, their name will pop up. But they are very empty, hollow, and they are miserable, and they're depressed. Why? Because these areas are lacking in their life. All right, family is lacking. They do not have a family. Doesn't mean just the family where you had taken birth. That's not the family. I mean, that is your family, of course, but anybody who also feels like your family. Okay, the family is missing. Then fifth house, children is missing. Then seventh house, no spouse. Ninth house, no guru. And 11th house, no friends. Yes. The more you become famous, the more people want to exploit you. The more people want to use you. And that is why no friends, you see. All enemies stabbing you at the back. So, therefore, if somebody is not having these links, these houses, then it is like saying Jupiter and Venus are missing from their chart. Okay? Because you see what happens. When you have a childbirth, what do people tell you? Congratulations. Yes. You just had a baby boy or a baby girl. When you get married, what do people say? Congratulations. You just got married. When you go to ninth house, when you get Diksha from a guru, when you find a guru, what do people say? Congratulations. And 11th house is any kind of gains. It can be financial gains also. So when you get a job, then also people say congratulations. When you get a promotion, then people say congratulations. All right. So that's what Jupiter and Venus, that is what they represent at the mundane level. All right. So if suppose somebody doesn't have any spiritual goals, they have no idea of the spirit or God or spirituality. They have no idea. At least if they have these things in their life, they will still be relatively very happy in their life, in their material life. Yes, they will be very happy. There are many people I know who have zero spiritual inquisitiveness, but still they have these areas in their life functioning reasonably well, because of which they are very happy. Now, of course, that happiness is of not much use, because they didn't use that happiness to inquire about God. That's their misfortune. Maybe in some other life they will do it, hopefully. But the point is, even if somebody has no idea of spirit and is totally materialistic, even then these houses can give a lot of happiness and comfort and fulfillment within the heart, because these houses, they technically satisfy the heart. But now they also have higher aspects. Jupiter and Venus, they also have higher things in life. Now, Jupiter has, everybody knows, but the problem is people don't know about Venus. And today we will discuss about that. Okay. So if you read the, which canto is it? 8th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam. That is the story of Bali Maharaj. Now, why I am bringing Bali Maharaj here? Because he is a very interesting character. See, many times, what do people tell? That, oh, this person cheated me. If I would have known, then I would have never done that. Yes, they always use this statement. If I would have known, if I knew, if only somebody told me, these kind of phrases people use. But imagine, I come and tell you that, my dear sir, my dear madam, tomorrow this thing is going to happen to you. And suppose, imagine, whatever I speak is the truth. All right, imagine it for one day. And then you know it, that yes, he's telling me it's going to happen. But imagine, I tell you that if you do this, you will lose everything. And you still do it. Wow. That's who is Bali Maharaj. That's what Bali Maharaj did. Yes, he is the descendant of the great Prahlad Maharaj. In the 7th canto, Prahlad Maharaj comes. Okay. And Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita that among the Daityas, I am Prahlad. Krishna says that. And then what happens? Bali Maharaj is doing this sacrifice to become Indra. All right. And then Lord Vishnu comes and he takes Vaman avatar, because he did not want that Bali Maharaj completes this sacrifice. Because if he would have done that, then he would have become Indra. But that is not a legitimate way to become. I mean it is, but it is technically, legally, it is a legal way to become Indra, but it's not a very good way. It's like overthrowing somebody and then going and sitting in their position. Although that's legally correct, but morally it was not correct. And the current Indra, his name is Purandar. And in the next Manvantara, okay, Bali Maharaj will be the next Indra. So Lord Vishnu came as Vamandev, a very small boy. And then he told to Bali Maharaj that, my dear Bali, now, because before the completion of the Yajna, the requirement was that all the people who ask charity, Bali Maharaj has to satisfy them at any cost. Without that, the Yajna would not be successful. And then all the Brahmins, they came and Bali Maharaj generously gave them charity. And then last was this small boy. And then Shukracharya, the guru of the demons, the Daityas, the Asuras, he came and he told to Bali Maharaj that, my dear Bali, you are my disciple. Please listen to me. This person who you are going to give charity, he is not an ordinary person. He is Vishnu himself. He is going to strip you from everything that you have. He is going to make you a pauper, a beggar, a penniless person. Please do not give any charity to this person. Please do not do that. I am instructing you. Please don't. बिकॉज इफ यू डू यू विल बी फिनिश्ड कंप्लीटली, कुछ भी नहीं बचेगा तेरे पास, कंगाल हो जाएगा तू. एंड देन बलि महाराज सेज दैट, नाउ बलि महाराज नोज व्हाट शुक्राचार्य इज सेइंग, ही इज नॉट जस्ट ब्लफिंग. बलि महाराज नोज, एंड ही इज ऑल्सो द डिसेंडेंट ऑफ द ग्रेट प्रहलाद, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट when he sees Vamandev, he understands that he is not just an ordinary child, he is Vishnu himself. And then Bali Maharaj says to Shukracharya that, my dear Guru, I disobey your instruction because whoever is asking charity must be given. And therefore now I will give charity. He is asking me 3 steps of land. And then he took the vow that I, Bali, take a vow that I will give 3 steps of land to this Vamandev. And then, of course, we all know what happened. You know, Vamandev measured with one of his, one foot, he measured the entire 14 planetary systems, the upper planetary realms, and then with the next, he measured the earth, the Bhuloka, and then he asked Bali Maharaj, my dear Bali, where will I keep my 3rd foot now? All right. And then Bali Maharaj said, you can keep it on top of my head because my head represents my ego. My ego is still there with me, you see. So that's the place. Even if you get the whole universe, but you have not got my ego. So put your head on my ego, which is represented by my head. As in Hindi, they say, sar jhuka diya. That means you have humiliated somebody, or somebody has been humiliated. Sar jhuk gaya, sar kat gaya hamara, naak kat gaya. So then Bali Maharaj is very happy. And Bali Maharaj is imprisoned, right? He's tied around by the snakes. And at the end, of course, Lord Vishnu blesses him that you will be the next Indra. And you will currently, till this Manvantara ends, all right, you will stay in Sutala. It is an underwater heavenly planet. It's in the lower planetary realms. It is more opulent than the heavens. And I will personally become your servant, your doorkeeper, your security guard, and protect you there from all odds. Wow, what a benediction. But the point is, after this whole drama ends, this Leela ends, Then Vamandev asks to Shukracharya that, my dear Daitya Guru Shukracharya, what happened to your disciple? He lost everything that he had. He became a beggar. He became a pauper. Why has such misfortune come unto your disciple? And now, Shukracharya, he could have said anything. But what he said shows his knowledge. Shukracharya said to Vamandev that, he said, my dear Lord, whatever discrepancies happen in anybody's life, or whatever mistakes one can commit, or whatever wrongdoings, whatever sins, but at the end, whoever chants your holy name, everything is nullified. Whoever chants your name at the end, attains all perfection, just like Bali Maharaj did at the end. So this means Venus doesn't only want that you just stay in matter. He doesn't want that you just stay with this luxuries and pleasure of sexuality or opposite sex. Venus doesn't want that. Venus wants you to give that. Venus wants you to enjoy that. And then look for spirituality, because he gets exalted in the sign of Pisces, which is the sign of Jupiter. That is where Venus ultimately finds happiness. Otherwise, he would have been exalted in some sign like Taurus or Gemini or Libra, or why not Scorpio? If Venus was only about sexuality, as many people think, then the best sign for him to get exalted is Scorpio. No better sign than Scorpio. He would have been millions and billions and trillions of times more exalted in Scorpio, right? But why does he go to Pisces? And Jupiter gives the higher philosophy in life. But Venus gives absorption. Venus gives you attraction. Venus gives you, in one way you can say, obsession. That's more of Rahu stuff. But obsession to what? Obsession to your spiritual path. Attraction to your spiritual path. Just by having knowledge, just by having gyan, just by doing spiritual practices, which Jupiter represents, nobody can continue their spiritual life. It is not possible. You need Venus in your spiritual journey. Otherwise, without that, you cannot function. It's not possible. You need all the planets in your spiritual journey. You need the moon. You need mental absorption, mental connection. You need sun, which means you need to be fixed. You need to have a spiritual vision. You need Saturn. You need discipline. You need structure. You need hard work. That's what Saturn is. You need Mercury. You need to understand books like the Bhagavad Gita. You see, you need to understand books. Without Mercury, you can't understand all this. Very complicated. I mean, not Sanskrit-wise, but to understand what is soul, to comprehend what am I doing in this material world. What do I need to do? For that, you need Mercury, for God's sake. You need all planets. And ultimately, you need Venus and you need Mars for that daring, that brahmacharya, for celibacy. And at the end, you need Venus, because Venus gives you that which will ultimately help you continue your spiritual path for long, 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 long time. Jupiter can introduce you to spirituality. And Sun can give you a spiritual vision, but Venus can give you absorption. Venus can give you attraction. Venus can give you obsession with spirituality. I mean, not in a negative sense, not a negative obsession, but a positive way. You are very much dedicated. It is like falling in love with your spiritual path. When a person falls in love with somebody, what does the person do? Very meticulously, the person arranges everything. Yes. The person becomes very creative. The person becomes very happy. The person feels that I don't need anything else in life. When somebody falls in love, that same thing with spirituality, that is what is the job of Venus. Venus is that factor which gives you that feel good factor. Yes. When I'm chanting mantras, how do I feel? Or am I just doing it because somebody told me to do? Why am I doing it? There you go. Venus is very essential. So the biggest remedy for Jupiter and Venus is to congratulate others, to see the good in others. That is the biggest remedy, because they represent all the good things in life. The moment you see a horoscope, what do you see? From tomorrow or from today or from now, don't see Sun, Moon, Rahu, Ketu, Saturn, Mars. Don't see all these planets. Just see where Jupiter and Venus are sitting. That should be the first thing that we see in the chart. That will tell us what will make the person happy. That will tell us what kind of congratulations a person can get. Yes? Because everybody wants appreciation in this world. If everybody is appreciated, then nobody will leave anybody. Yes? And on the other hand, if we only find faults with others, what is finding faults? Saturn. The moment you are finding fault with somebody, you are inviting Saturn into your relationship. For God's sake, please don't do that. And it is evident in the situation in today's Kali Yuga. You can see this. Just go to any YouTube video. Just go and see the comments. All nasty. Most of them are filthy, disgusting comments. All abusing each other. If it is from one political party, the other political party fans or followers will abuse that person. Anything, any, all kind of negativity is going on. They are inviting Saturn into their own life. Saturn is what? Tears, sorrow, suffering, misery, pain, hurt. All this is Saturn. You want Saturn? Nobody wants Saturn. Everybody wants Jupiter and Venus. So if you want Jupiter and Venus, you also have to give Jupiter and Venus to others. If you are giving Saturn to others, you can never get Jupiter and Venus in return, because you get what you give. All right. And when you see that somebody is lacking these things, try to go and give them this. If somebody is crying, try to go and show that there are good things in their life. But what is our tendency? When we see something good in others, we become envious, envious like snakes. And then we start barking like dogs. We start criticizing them. We start insulting them. Not directly maybe, but from back door. We start gossiping. Yes. So all these are typical Saturn and Rahu traits. So if you are indulging in Saturn and Rahu, Jupiter and Venus will never bless you. For the next 1,000,000,000 lifetimes, they will never bless you. And you will roam in this world headlessly without any feel-good factor. You will roam like a dead corpse. It doesn't matter how much money you have, how many followers you have, or what is your status, how many subordinates you have. These are all useless things. If you don't have Jupiter and Venus, if you have them, then these all other name, fame, money, popularity, then these things will have some value. These things are like the big zeros. And Jupiter and Venus is like that one. You see, one and big zeros. If it is one zero, then it's zero. If there are 1,000 zeros, they're all zeros. But if there is a one, then it becomes, 100, 1,000, million, billion, trillion. So whenever you see zeros, put this one in front of them, all right? And appreciate others for their goodness. And by that, you will see that Jupiter and Venus is also coming in your life. Because when you see good in others, you will also be good, and you will also behave good in a good way, and others will come and appreciate you, okay? Otherwise, if you are sticking to Saturn and Rahu, you are inviting disaster into your life, all right? So stay away from Saturn and Rahu and stay with Jupiter and Venus. That will make you happy, prosperous, and fulfilled in your life. Otherwise, God knows. All right, so thank you very much for your patient hearing. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up at the end, and please share it with somebody who wants to understand what Jupiter and Venus represents. And if you want a consultation from me, then you can go down to the description section of my videos, where you will find the link to my website to book a reading with me. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him, and you must find Him. Oh no, you will only find Him if you appreciate others. All right. Thank you very much. And see you soon again next time. Bye-bye.